Learn more at KeevMore.
Okay students, now we are in the next lecture of the electrochemistry, that is corrosion. Okay, so you might be thinking corrosion should not be in this process because it is regarding the metals. Okay, but it is not so. Metals are undergoing corrosion, but it is not a part of the metallurgy because corrosion is also electrochemical cell. In this cell what happens, oxidation also takes place and reduction also takes place. Okay, so actually corrosion is an electrochemical process, understood? So that's why corrosion is taken and studied in the electrochemistry. Okay, so first what is corrosion? Okay, slowly eating away of metal by atmospheric gases is called as a corrosion. Slowly metal will be converted into some other compounds. Okay, so that some other compounds are, they can be compounds formed by the metal with atmospheric gases. Most of the atmospheric gases will be oxygen. Okay, oxygen will come, suppose this is a metal surface, atmospheric gases will come and taken away, eaten away or converted into compounds. Okay, so that is called as a corrosion. So there is some related term and very most of the students feels same. What is that? Rusting. Okay, what is that? Rusting. So rusting and corrosion, we cannot say completely different, we cannot say completely same, because rusting is a specialized term. What it is? Rusting is a specialized term. When specialized term used for, it is a specialized term used for iron only. Okay, for what it is? Iron only. Okay, so but corrosion is a general term, process is same. Slow eating away of, in this metal what you should write? Iron. By the atmospheric gases is called rusting. But suppose zinc, then we cannot say rusting. Suppose silver, we cannot say rusting. Copper, we cannot say rusting. Okay, so it does not mean that only iron undergo rusting, other metals also undergo rusting. For them corrosion is used. For iron, we can use rusting also, we can use corrosion also. Okay, so generalized term for the same process. Okay, generalized term for the same process is called as a corrosion. Okay, so it is only separate treatment is given for the iron, because the quantity wise, the existence wise, this iron corrosion is very fast and higher in quantity. Therefore special term is given, like in electromagnetic waves, photon and quantum. Quantum is a general term. So for light waves also we can use quantum, but it is also called as photon. So for light we can use quantum and photon, but the other things, for other metals we cannot use the quantum photon. This is only used for the light. Light is also electromagnetic wave. Like iron also electromagnetic wave only. Sorry, iron also metal. So metal corrosion is a combined term. Okay, but iron is a special term other than the corrosion. We can say iron is corroded, we can say iron is rusted, but zinc only corroded, zinc cannot be rusted. Okay, so that is the difference between rusting and corrosion. Okay, now how we will say that rusting or corrosion is an electrochemical process? Because there is one special term called as a depolarizer. Okay, in this terms depolarizer. Okay, that also I will talk depolarizer. Okay, so what is depolarizer? Does any substance which helps to take away electron from the metal. Okay, so any substance which facilitates in taking away of electron from metal is called as a depolarizer, removing the electron. Is that understood? So that is called as a depolarizer. Okay, now in this depolarizer, metal and how like oxygen is necessary, then what the metal will be losing electron. Let us take iron. Okay, react with the atmospheric oxygen, it is forming Fe2O3. So here iron is undergoing oxidation. Okay, oxygen is undergoing reduction. So whenever there are two elements undergoes oxidation and reduction, there will be transfer of electrons. There will be what? Transfer of electron. Transfer of electron itself is a electrochemical cell. Okay, so before going further, you write down depolarizer. Definition is very important. Okay, noted. So now I will explain in the aspect of the corrosion in electrochemical cell. Okay, so for every electrochemical cell there must be three parts. What are these three parts? Anode, cathode and electrolyte. Okay, suppose this is the metal surface. Okay, so this metal surface, here metal is undergoing oxidation. Okay, so once they lose the electrons, for transferring from one place to another place, a thin coating of water is required. Okay, so let us take this as a water. Understood? So water will act as a electrolyte. Water will act as what? Electrolyte. It will carry the electron from this place to another place. Okay, so by losing this electron, it is converted into what? Mn plus. So that electron will be available here, and that oxygen will be at oxygen or hydrogen, any gas. Okay, not necessary that oxygen only must be available, any other gas also possible, but 99.9% what is present? Oxygen. So that oxygen will take 4 electron, let us take, then it will form as a 2O2-. Okay, so this 2- and Mn plus, they will form the metal oxide. What it will form? M2, this oxygen On. Let us take, this is a substance name. So three things you can observe: metal is anode, oxygen is cathode, and water is a electrolyte. Okay, so let us take iron, it will be 3 Fe2O3. Okay, that time Fe will be anode and oxygen will be cathode, water is necessary. Okay, and water is not required in very big quantity, only it should facilitate the electron movement. Understood? A thin layer of the water is also sufficient, but it will take place at two different places. Okay, so at one place oxidation, another place reduction, and both will combine to form a compound called as a oxide. Actually, corroded compound is only oxide only. Okay, it is a compound formation. Is it understood? Note down this diagram. Okay, these are the reactions. As an electrode, iron I am taking as a corrosion, or that is rusting. Okay, so iron undergoes oxidation from Fe to Fe2+. Further, it can be oxidized to Fe3+ also. And cathode, O2+, 2H2O+, 4 electron gives these 4 electron. You can take it as a 2, 2 and 4 also. So that 4 electron will be converted into OH-. So Fe, OH-, then they will converted as a dot XH2O. Okay, what it will form? HCFE2O3 dot XH2O. This is what the Rust formula. What is the formula? Ferric oxide then hydrate. Hydrate value will depends upon the condition. More suppose it is in more corrosion takes place, more rusting takes place when more water is present, because what is that required? Electrolyte is required. Okay, corrosion cannot takes place under dry condition due to absence of the water. Okay, and if water is suppose contaminated, that means some salts are added, then electrolytic property will improve. So impure water is a better enhancing for the corrosion. Okay, pure water is less favorable for the corrosion, but the impure water containing the sodium chloride or some salt will improve the corrosion process. Is it understood? So there are some more terms which we will discuss. Okay, first one is how to arrest this corrosion. This corrosion is a very bad thing. We should not make it happen. Understood? To stop the corrosion. Okay, how to stop the corrosion? There are many process. Okay, and when the corrosion will improve, when the corrosion will increase? In presence of the moist condition, like water is present. Okay, impurities are present, because impurities improves the conductivity properties of water and they will act as a better conductor. Okay, and suppose cuts. Okay, suppose if it is smooth surface, no problem. If it is cuts, then water can store over here, surface area increased, because corrosion is starts at the surface only. Understood? So cuts and bends, so these are the some problems where corrosion will improve. Okay, so for that, what we should make? We should stop the corrosion. First one, we can, these are the three steps. Okay, first step is cathodic protection. Okay, cathodic protection, first one. Okay, otherwise second one is the sacrificial protection. Sacrificial protection. Okay, and third one is noble coating. What coating? Noble coating. Okay, so actually these two are the same only. Understood? First, what we will do? Cathodic protection. Suppose this is the metal or this is the iron object or metal object which we want to prevent it from the corrosion. Okay, then we will internally connect it with the metal which is more reactive. Understood? Suppose oxygen wants to react with the object which is made up of, let us take iron. Okay, now we are connecting it with the aluminium. Understood? So then what happens when they are thermally conducting, connected with? Understood? So this electron will be preferably given by this aluminium rather than iron, because it is more reactive. Understood? So this is accepting the electron. That time this will act as a cathode, this will act as an anode. That's why it is called as a cathodic protection, or it is called as cathodic protection. Same thing can be done by the coating. Suppose this is the iron object. Okay, now this is what called as a galvanization. Zinc, if you are doing the coating, then when oxygen comes in contact with iron, so zinc will be losing the electron than the iron. Okay, that is called as a galvanization. And the coating, if it is made up of the, like a nickel coating. What coating? Here also coating only, but nickel coating. Nickel is a noble metal. Okay, or even paint also, no problem. Barrier protection. If we use the paint, then it is called as a barrier protection. Okay, so barrier protection can be done by the paint, grease or oil, any substance which is inert to the oxygen. When oxygen comes, either they will not react and they will not able to, they will be protecting the iron, they will be in between. Okay, so they will avoid the reaction by forming as a protective layer. Understood? So obstruction, they will provide the obstruction to contact of the oxygen with our metal. Understood? That is called as a barrier protection or noble coating. So these are the three methods by which we can protect the object or metal from the corrosion. Is it understood? So write down, cathodic protection is this one, sacrificial protection is this one, noble coating is this one. Noble coating or barrier protection also, okay. Understood? Note down this. I hope you understood everything about the cathodic protection and all. So we will do the some questions related to this about the electrochemistry. Okay.